Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to begin this variety session. Thank you very much for a 2 days powerful content on R&D, making India as a global destination. On behalf of FICCI, on behalf of the government, on behalf of our partners and industries, we'd like to thank all equity holders who have dedicated their time, they dedicated their passion in making India as a destination. And this endeavor, FICCI, is going to scale further. Unfortunately, our dear friend and our strategic partner from the government, Dr. Arvind Mitra, has to move for an immediate minister meeting. So I will be first summing up. He has given some points from the government side, which I'll be representing him in this valedictory session. On behalf of the government is very happy to see FICCI as a partner, and they want to create this enabling platform for industries. They are looking forward for innovative public-private partnership. And on behalf of the Dr. Mitra, who heads the International Science and Technology Division of Department of Science and Technology, he requested me to announce that any industries who are looking for collaborative research and development with the government across sector, they can approach Dr. Arvind Mitra, who heads the International Division at DST, and government would be more willing to create more public-private partnership in this endeavor. Ladies and gentlemen, as you are aware that our Honorable Prime Minister in our last Science Congress on 3rd of January 2013 made an announcement that government will be keen to see private sector more participating in the research and development, and they will be keen of considering more innovative platforms with industries. So this is a great message from the government, and you can take up academia, industries, institution. So we would like to support this endeavor from FICCI side. Now, from FICCI side, when we take this initiative for India, we thought that the research and development will be a key differentiator in our future economy. And we have realized this factor, and we are moving industries to participate more in a committed research and development investment. With this mandate, as you all aware, that FICCI has Center for Science, Technology, Innovation and Commercialization. We are already running three public-private partnerships for the government. I'd like to highlight here that we are working with Department of Science and Technology and the corporate sector in a program called India Innovation Growth Program, which actually commercialize the science, monetize science for commercialization. And it's working for the last 7 years. So we have converted a lot of science innovation into the market, and it's going strong. We are running a program with the Ministry of Defense. First time the Ministry of Defense came forward. Their research institution, DRDO, partnered with FICCI in 2009 to commercialize their technologies into the market, this research into the market. That program also working very well. And now we have a partner, international partnership from USAID, who at first time came in a partnership mode, and they partnered with FICCI and Technology Development Board in assisting science, innovation, technology, commercialization for social impact. So the government also has shown faith in a chamber like us, and they feel that until unless science are connected to the industries, you can't create an impact. So the message is very clear from the industry and the government side. And from FICCI, we would like to create an ecosystem. We would like to extend more equitable partnership with every equity holder. And we like to make India as a destination of global R&D. Now, I will ask my other speakers to share their thought. I will hand over to Bruce Lander. We will be announcing Bruce Lander represent GBI, which is an institution supported in a form of United Nations. We will be working together, and next year we'll request Bruce to be a part of this forum, where Bruce, through his network across the countries, like to bring countries, institutions, United Nations to work more closely with academia, Indian academia, Indian industries, and the Indian government. With this mandate, I'd like to request Bruce for a statement.
Excellent. Thank you. As always, it's great to work with you and your enthusiasm and vision. As for those of you who heard me speak earlier, the elements of our experience are that no matter what kind of R&D you're doing, no matter what kind of innovation you're doing, it begins and ends with markets. People have to buy products. They have to solve problems. And one of the things that I've had the pleasure of doing is visiting countries around the world who are desperate for solutions. And so what we want to bring here through FICCI is market-making collaboration, buyers and sellers coming together to sign agreements to solve problems. And in the essence, it is the final stage of R&D that we all look for, which is revenues being generated to support the businesses that are created. And so our whole initiative will be around entrepreneurial collaboration. It isn't about starting new companies per se. It's about coming up with creative ways to solve problems and put proven technologies into play.
Thank you, Bruce. And we extend our fruitful partnership for expandable reach for our Indian industries institution to reach through your network globally. And also invite the global network to come and work with them for collaborative research, R&D, innovation, and commercialization. Now I'd like to hand over to our FICCI co-chairman, Mr. Sharendra Potwal, who is a managing director of Battelle India. And Battelle, you know, is one of the global firm which has already proven research and development across the world. And I'd like to request Sharendra to share his thought.
Thank you, Nirankarji. And I would like to suggest a word of thanks for a number of participants as well as speakers as well as the organizers. And it is a pleasure to do that. I have been attending science and R&D conferences in India for quite some time. And what I have observed is that there are trade organizations that do conferences here, but R&D focus is increasing. 4 years ago, I attended a conference. There were about 130 attendees. Then 2 years ago, I attended a conference, again organized by FICCI, on industry-academia relationship. There were 350 participants. Today, we saw this organization, a Global R&D Summit, Destination India, 650 participants. So my thinking is to, and I think this is a challenge that FICCI will have to face. Next time there is a conference like this, we better find a venue where there may be 1,200 participants. Because it's doubling every time we do it again and again. And I think there is a real interest in R&D. So, and now I think India is coming of age where India is beginning to solve its own problems, looking to develop technology where it can take the technology to the world outside rather than bring the technology from outside to us. To us. So that's a big change. Now, there were, I don't know if you realize, there were 60 speakers here in the last 2 days. Many of them are extremely qualified and perhaps they can speak for 4 hours at a stretch. So the difficulty in organizing an event like this is that to give somebody 5 to 15 minutes and condense their thoughts, sometimes the audience is left with a hunger and appetite to ask more questions, which are not answered. So, of course, we will have to look for innovative ways to do such R&D conferences in the future where we can accommodate more and more participation from the audience. So that is a thing. An event like this does not happen with one or two individuals. A lot of planning went into it. The S&T and Innovation Committee of FICCI First, I started thinking about it about almost 6 months ago, and discussed several formats, came up with this format finally. After that, the vision of Mr. Nirankar Saxena, we started to, Deepanjan put it, executed that vision. Imagine coordinating with 60 senior persons who were on the dais at different occasions, at different times in the last 2 days. Coordinating with all of them, making sure all the protocols are followed. Fiki and the 20 persons from Fiki who helped in putting it all together really deserve an applause from all of us. Another silent partner that you see is MM Active, and I understand they also put at least 20 persons to this conference, and they also deserve an applause. This conference, of course, will not take place without sponsors. And you see all those sponsors on our right, on my right and my left side panels. So there are gold sponsors, bronze sponsors, associate sponsors, and a number of other program sponsors and supporting sponsors. It is very important to have that sponsorship to make this happen. Now, it is going to be the case that more and more persons will like to participate in these conferences in the future. So we will be thinking about bigger venue, bigger participation, and so on. I would like to also thank the Department of Science and Technology and the state sponsor here. The leadership of FICCI will be a common guidance, and I think we look to that. We at Battelle also worked hard in preparing that knowledge paper. I would that knowledge paper, some of you have asked me about, that is available on the FICCI website. So you can download that paper and look at that. So with that, I would like to say my thanks again to all the participants, organizers, speakers, and sponsors. Thank you.
Thank you, Shailendraji, for your, I think, very effective and useful address. We welcome your leadership in FICCI Science and Technology Committee and your vision and your contribution, your knowledge contribution for India as a knowledge paper, as a direction which FICCI has endorsed with Battelle together, which will give our country a purpose to move and expand for R&D. Ladies and gentlemen, this event wouldn't have possible without our partner MM Active, and especially the proactive support of Mr. Ravi Barodkar and his team. We like to place on record our gratitude for his team and request Ravi to share his thought.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Nirankar. In fact, thanks once again for, you know, reviving our old association. I remember we started India R&D way back in 2005-2006. That did for a couple of years, and again this year it was a good experience that we could revive it. As Shailendra has nicely taken a complete overview of the event, he also mentioned to you how this event has gone through for the last 2 days. And Bruce also stressed about the collaborations on the markets. And here I would like to add that this year, we have experimented a new tool here at the Global R&D Summit, that is Interlinks. So we threw it open to our registered delegates, and the 90 delegates registered for the collaborations, and they mutually sent the request. And I'm happy to share with you that 31 meetings did happen here. And I'm sure these interactions will continue beyond these 2 days also. And overall, in last 2 days, I think what is the take home for us, if we think that be it a national or international, all the speakers, I think they all believed in the India story. They all stressed, they all expressed confidence about the innovations here, about the R&D institutions here. But at the same time, there was also a caution, another line put forward, that we still need to strengthen the ecosystem here. So be it a researcher, innovator, entrepreneur, institution, or a corporate, and I will say be it even the policymakers. So whatever we are, we need to further strengthen this. And if we can do that, I think that will be the real take home for this global R&D summit. So with this, I think, I wish all the delegates, all the speakers, all the participants here, best luck to continue their work, to find better solutions, to come out with more collaborations, and to further strengthen this R&D ecosystem. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ravi. I think a very good statement. And rounding up the statement from Fiki's side, we'd like to make a bold statement that the next R&D 2014, we have an active interest from United Nations. We got an interest during the conference from United States, from Germany. The Indo-German director said they'd like to bring Germany on board. And we got active interest from Israel. We like to globalize and show what India has and what India has in terms of content from the academia, from the institution, from the industry to attract global investors coming to India, making as a global R&D hub for India. FICCI is very committed, and we like to, I think, see our global leaders on this platform. We would be happy, and we'll making a request to all our global leaders to come and participate and take the benefit of the country, which is a legendary country, where the country that produces a great legend like Chanakya, Aryabhatta, C.V. Raman. And also, we want to make India as a destination of our innovative strategic research, development, innovation platform for the whole world. So with this, before ending up, I would like to extend my warm welcome to my FICCI dedicated team and MM Active dedicated team who had been working together for last many months to make it possible, especially the team led by Captain Upal in MM Active and the team led by Dipanjan Banerjee from FICCI and his team. I would like to congratulate both of them on this initiative. And I'd like to thank the hotels, Ashoka Hotel, ITDC, who have extended the warm facility for us and make us all arrangement possible for the conference. Our sincere gratitude to the hotel staff for making this all-enabled facility wonderful. Now, with these words, we're looking forward to seeing you in 2014 Global R&D. I conclude this session. Thank you.